I just got out of class early, so I'm about to head over to McKinley to get a couple of my shots. I think I need like five, maybe four or five or something, or six. I don't know. But when I went to my consultation thing, the doctor lady, she was like, yeah, you could probably get like two in each arm or something. I might get like two in one arm today, but I don't know if I can go like armless for the rest of the day. So we'll see how this goes. I'm finally working on getting stuff out of the way. Yep. So I just got two. I don't know if you could see the other one for me. But anyways, one's in the shoulder up here, and one's in my tricep back there. There it is. This one, because I know you care so much, this one is hepatitis A, and she was like freaking me out about it because, yeah, I'll put my shirt back on. But she was like freaking me out because she was saying like, oh yeah, that one hurts, and because like most immunizations and stuff are like half a cc, Hep A is like a whole cc or something. So she was like, yeah, that one's painful. And then polio, the one I got my tricep, is, oh well, polio I just said. And she was asking if I wanted to get all four today, but I didn't want to because I work later tonight and I have to be like lifting stuff all night long, like cases of water and pop and everything. So that's why I went the safe route and only got two. So I'm gonna go back in a couple days and get the other two. But anyways, she went to give me the shot and she asked which one I wanted first. And I didn't know if I wanted like the one that didn't hurt first or I wanted the one that did hurt. And so I was like, I don't know, what do you recommend? And then she didn't even answer, so she just started talking. And she's like, so, like, I don't know. I think she brought up, like, giving blood, because I told her I give blood, so, like, this shouldn't be that bad. And she was like, yeah, like, where do you give blood, blah, blah, blah. And then she, like, jabbed it in. And it was, like, kind of hurting, but, like, it wasn't. I was expecting it to hurt, and it wasn't bad. My arm just felt really, like, tired after that. And she did Hep A first. And then we were talking and she went to do polio and I was freaking out because it was in the tricep. And I don't know if you can see that. Oh, it's bright. Sorry if you couldn't just see that whole time. She went to do polio and like I didn't feel it at all. She's like, you're gonna feel a pinch. I didn't feel anything the whole time she was doing everything. And she's like, oh, most people like think that one hurts a lot, but it didn't. So I'm pretty buff. So that was my awesome experience. Oh yeah, that last clip was me waiting in the waiting room afterward for 10 minutes and they gave me some little orange juice and I was sad because my arm felt like it was falling asleep. Not falling asleep, it just feels really like, oh, it's like heavy. The polio one doesn't hurt at all. The Hep A one, man. My arm's just like, like that. My, like, shoulder just feels tired or heavy. I don't know how to explain it. Meh, you've had shots before, so. Whatever, two shots down, two to go, and then I have my other, like, oral medication things I have to pick up, too. I'll do that sometime. Party time. Holy cats and biscuits. I just had my interview at the dining hall, and it was actually my student supervisor that just interviewed me, so it wasn't too bad because like he's really cool, but I was really nervous, but I think I did fine. They're like talking about it now, and I'm heading to class, and then after class I have to work, so I'll see them again. There's a bus. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so they said they'll let me know their decision sometime soon or something. But she did ask if I'd be able to come in, like, before school started, like, next year. Come in so I could be trained and everything. And I did let her know, like, my lease starts August 15th, and then we have work week and stuff after that, so I hope that doesn't have a huge problem. But we'll see. I'll be really excited to get this job because she's been pushing for me to do it. So hopefully that's a plus. Hi. I'm on my way to a meeting. We have an education association meeting right now, and one of the senators is coming to talk to us about education issues and what the future looks like and everything. So we're hoping for a really big turnout because usually we don't have very many people at our meetings. So I don't know, we're sending school-wide emails, so hopefully we have more people. Yeah, I guess I'll see what he has to say. Oh yeah, when I said one of the senators, I said that on purpose because sue me, but I don't know our senators. Sorry, that's a bad thing. It's like Frerichs. I might be saying that wrong. Anyways, he's the one coming to talk to us.
He is running for re-election in November, so please help me in welcoming Ms. Senator Michael Frerichs.
I appreciate being introduced as an exciting speaker. I hope to live up to that. I'm not sure I can. I'm going to sit for a little bit here tonight. I have not been feeling the best the last 24 hours of lawyer jokes out there. And I posit the reason they say, you know, a lawyer, a doctor, is because these are professions that generally pay well. And I figure, like, well, if, you know, you can make a six-figure salary doing it, that's something to respect. I think that just shows a missed priorities in our culture. But I also just really believe, like, if you want to have talented people, you have to pay them well. And if you want people to respect it, and our culture, one of the signs of respect is pay. You know, I don't think we necessarily respect people like Madonna or other pop singers necessarily just because they think they're good for society. Some people would. You know, she makes millions and millions of dollars, and that's something we look up to. So anyway, I'm rambling now a little bit about myself. So I serve in the General Assembly now and want to ask, you know, why do people have such a bad idea of teachers these days? I mean, I thought we looked up to our teachers. I thought we respected education and our students. And I think in general people do, but there is a national campaign going on to demonize and don't feel just, you know, singled out as teachers, but public employees. So firefighters, janitors, in public institutions, police officers, pretty much all under attack because of a national campaign going on. And you can see it if you watch certain news stations more than others. Fox News helps to fan the flames here. And some people say, well, you're just paranoid. You think people are coming after you. I tell you, I don't believe I'm paranoid. This is something that has been going on. And they talk about our problems in our economy in terms of how public employees are bankrupting us and how public employee pensions are what ruined our economy. And it's these lavish salaries we pay to people that are destroying our economy. And I don't know, I tend to think that there are probably some things that happened on Wall Street in the early 2000s, call me up to 2007, 2008, probably played a larger role. But the people who are interested in pushing this story are people who aren't so much interested in reforming Wall Street, aren't interested in reforming the banking sector. A lot of the money funding this stuff comes from large businesses, and it's a very common tactic in politics. If you have a problem right here that you don't want people to address, then we need to distract them. And so an awful lot of money is spent, say, looking at these public employees, looking at the generous pensions they've got. And they've convinced a lot of people that the problem is public employees because they spent a lot of money, a lot of time talking about this. And so you're under attack, and you see it in Wisconsin, you see it in Ohio, you see it in Indiana. And I think if Bill Brady had been elected 2 years ago in Illinois, you'd see it going on here in Illinois to a greater extent. But make no doubt, it is going on, and it's been going on for a little while. And I assume since all of you have taken time out of your week at 7 o'clock on a Wednesday evening to come hear a legislator talk to your group, you probably are somewhat aware of this. And you saw this a couple years ago with moving to a two-tier pension system. And I want to talk a little bit about that, even though it's past, it's water under the bridge. It gives you a sort of idea of what's going on. Because
I'm almost back at the house, and I'm coming back from the meeting right now. It was interesting listening to the senator and what he had to say and everything, but about maybe 60% of it was completely over my head, because as you know, I just don't follow politics very much, and I know I should, and I really want to start, but I don't know, every year just kind of like slips my mind, and then it's like too late, so eventually I'll do it, I promise. But for everyone that went to the meeting, if you showed up early, they had like a table of free things you could get. So I chose this book that's supposed to be really inspiring. And so it seems like a really quick read. So that's cool. And then in the raffle, I finally won a t-shirt, which I've been wanting all semester because they're really cute. And I'll show you when I get home. But oh, it was pretty nice. That's all. What? No way. It's crazy. So, here's the winning ticket that I had. 358 winning numbers. And I won this awesome shirt. Dun, dun, dun. Let's see. I think it's really cute. So, maybe I'll wear it tomorrow. I don't know. I also got this book.
What's up?
Hello.
What?
Hello.
What are you trying to do?
The camera.
Oh.
But it's about how to experience the true joy of life. And I guess it's inspirational. I don't know. We'll see. It was free, so can't be too bad.